here we are back on the back at Camel's Hump State Park. This is the Burrows Trail trailhead, and it's about 3 degrees. And while my brother's off in Jamaica, I'm gonna try to get as far up on Camel's Hump as I can. It's early January. We had some rain that washed away a lot of the snow, but then it got into the single digits and froze most of the wet stuff. So kind of treacherous, but I have my micro spikes on and pretty much insulated, so we'll see how far we can go. All right, see you later. There's Camel's Hump, and you can see the snow up here. It looks like it didn't really rain too much or turn to snow, but it's all hardened snow and ice, as opposed to down below, it's not as deep, but it's beautiful up here, nice and quiet. That's where we're going. I guess we're meandering around. The last half mile is supposed to be really tough. The rest of it is just up and down switchbacks. So we'll see. One step in front of the other. Big smile on my face because I almost have goose pimples. It was goosebumps. I don't know if they're pimples or bumps, but we're in a spruce and pine section, and the trees are starting to get smaller, stunted a bit. And Camel's Hump is above tree line, and every time I get up to this height, we're way up there right now. We still have a ways to go, but it just puts a smile on my face. I love it. It's just so beautiful, and I just love being out here. So anyway, feeling good. You can see the trail. One little here. The trail is nothing but ice, but it's above the rocks and stuff, so it's actually better than it would have been, say, on Wednesday when it was close to 50 degrees in Vermont. Because it just makes for mud, and all this trail turns into water and ice up here. So it just meanders around through this pine, and it's just beautiful. Some birch. We're heading towards, it seems, Camel's Hump now. We've been doing switchbacks back and forth, sort of away from it. But you can see some of the peaks across the way. There's not a lot of views on the Burrows Trail until you get above tree line. The trail we maybe will come down, the Forest City Trail, supposedly has a lot more views. But this is the most direct way up. Also the most popular. But we didn't make it up this far when I came with Moose earlier in late fall, early winter. But just pan around. You can see. Beautiful. clearing, which is the top, near the top of Camel's Hump. Actually coming down a little bit. We're at the clearing. Let's see. This says 20 miles to Burrows Trail, which is where we came up. The sky is still cloudy. Made it! Where's the view? Figured that. No, yeah, I'm kidding. Oh, 0.3, not bad. Oh, feels good up here. Yeah. Yeah. Well, you know, earlier, so when it came through, so maybe. Well, this is a long trail south, this way, that way. Well, 0.3 away from the summit. This is the way we came. Back up here, long trail north, which if you want to go to Canada, it's the way to go. They do the long trail, I'll be coming through here. And here is plaque. Camel Sump has been designated a registered natural landmark in 1968. Camel Sump is, it's right up there. That's where we gotta go. Alright, so climbing. You can see what's around us. Field. see it. Here we are, sun is setting, and we're coming out of the trail to the trailhead, and just signed out at the kiosk over here, and there's the car, and I'm a little sore from coming down, but all in all, these micro spikes worked perfect on the ice, didn't slip at all. It was really cold up there at the top, but what a way to end it. This is Millet time. Now for a nice cold beer somewhere to end the perfect day. So we did the hump. We got over the hump, the Camel's hump. So that's it. Another adventure in the books. All right, see you next time. I really miss Moose.